Prologue. A dragon was trying to hide in the storm. Lightning flickered across the dark clouds. Viter clutched his fragile cargo closer. If he could make it over the mountains, he'd be safe. He'd escaped the Sky Dragon's palace unseen, and the secret cave was so close. But his theft had not been as stealthy as he thought, and eyes as black as obsidian were already tracking him from below. The enormous dragon on the mountain ledge had pale gold scales that radiated heat like a desert horizon. Her black eyes narrowed, watching the gleam of silver wings far up in the clouds. She flicked her tail, and behind her, two more dragons rose to the sky and dived into the heart of the storm. A piercing shriek echoed off the mountains as their talons seized the moon-pale ice dragon. "Bind his mouth," the waiting dragon ordered as her soldiers dropped Viter on the slick, wet ledge in front of her. He was already inhaling, ready to attack. "Quickly!" One of the soldiers grabbed a chain from the pile of smoldering coals. He threw it around the ice dragon's snout, clamping his jaws together with a sizzling smell of burning scales. Viter let out a muffled scream.
"Too late."
The sand dragon's forked tongue slithered in and out of her mouth.
"You won't be using your freezing death breath on us, ice dragon. You was carrying this, Queen Burn," said one of the soldiers, handing her a dragon egg.
Burn squinted at the egg through the downpour.
"This is not an Icewing egg," she hissed. "You stole this from the Skywing Palace."
The Icewing stared back at her. Hissing steam circled his snout, where the hot chains met cold silver scales.
"You thought you could get away unnoticed, didn't you?"
Burn said.
"My Skywing ally is not a fool. Queen Scarlet knows everything that happens in her kingdom. Her lookouts reported an Icewing thief sneaking away, and I decided finding you might add some violence to my boring visit."
Burn held the large egg up to the light of the fire and turned it slowly. Red and gold shimmered below the pale, smooth surface.
"Yes, this is a Skywing egg about to hatch," Burn mused. "Why would my sister send you to steal a Skywing dragonette? Blaze hates any dragon younger and prettier than she is."
She thought for a moment as rain drummed on the ledge around them.
"Useless. The brightest night is tomorrow."
Her tail flicked up like a scorpion's, the poisonous barb inches from Viter's eyes.
"You're not in Blaze's army, are you? You're one of those insipid underground peacemongers."
"The talons of peace?" said one of the soldiers. "You mean they're real?" Burn snorted.
"A few worms crying over a little blood.
Unwrap his chains. He won't be able to freeze us until his scales cool down." The enormous sand dragon leaned closer as her soldier pulled the chain away.
"Tell me, Ice Dragon, do you really believe in that pompous old Nightwing's prophecy?"
"Haven't enough dragons died for your war?"
snarled Viter, wincing at the pain in his jaws.
"All of Peria has suffered for the last 12 years. The prophecy says..."
"I don't care.
No prophecy decides what happens to me," Burn interrupted.
"I'm not letting a bunch of words or baby dragons choose when I die or what I bow to. We can have peace when my sisters are dead and I am Queen of the Sandwings."
Her venomous tail dipped closer to the silver dragon.